Welcome back to another video, guys. This one is focusing on the EI Spirit Slash, or also known as the EI Counter. First of all, let me say, they are tough, and I suck at them too if I fight a monster I've never fought before. So, today I'm going to show you how I approach practicing them, and yeah, let's get started. First of all, the most important thing you want to do, get rid of your cat. Dog is fine, you can make them wait. But the reason behind that is you want the monster to always attack you so you can land those counters and the bodies just get in the way. So yeah, definitely leave your cat behind. Dog is fine. Now let's get started. So once you enter the stance, it's important to keep in mind that your character will sheath the weapon after 3.5 seconds. So in order to play around that, you have two options. The first one is to hit the X button. Do the little poke with A and then go into the stance again. Or you can also roll out of it, do the ZR attack and then go into the sheath again. Both of these options are equally fast, so it doesn't really matter, but it's important that it becomes muscle memory and you don't have to think about it. Alright, so I'm just gonna do a showcase hunt on Magnamalo because I think he's a good training partner, but also Diablos works great and Tigrex too. I chose Magnamalo because I'm pretty comfortable with it, so I can show it to you guys. Watch out for the roar here. I could have used the EA counter there. But I was kinda talking, and it's hard to do stuff and talking at the same time. So yeah, I'm only going to focus on the EA counters for now. Do an attack, go into the stance. This is taking too long before he's attacking me, so do it again. You can also go into another EI stance right after you land a successful counter. And this is important, it needs to be a successful counter, otherwise you can't do it. And you need to be early with the input. So just play around here a little bit, now is a good time. Hit that. Sadly couldn't connect it. Taking too long to attack me, so do that again. Also, Quick Sheath level 3 is a must-have in my opinion. It's so good on Longsword. That's a roar. I think that would have taken too long. So you don't want to ES stance the first move, but the second one. If you counter the first one, you're not always safe before he does the second one. Hit that. Go into the stance again. That's not a good move. Now would be a good time. Just play around here a little bit. Yeah, that's a crappy move. Now's a good time. Also now maybe. Don't like that move. So get out of there. That's the jump. Alright, that's a topple. So I'm not gonna do anything here, so I don't want him to die that quick, so I can show you guys some more clips. Or gameplay rather, I should say. Yeah, alright. Great Izuchi is ruining the day. Yeah, these tail moves are really good practice. They may seem hard to hit at first, but you will get there. Let's see what he does here. That's the fireball. Going to. I think that would have been early enough for that follow-up attack. But yeah, only with Quick Sheath level 3. Otherwise, my advice would be to keep two wirebugs. And so you can do the Serene Pose after the successful EA counter. So I'm just gonna play around again. Yeah, that was bad. Now would be a good time, I think. No, it's taking too long. Hit that. Alright, and we got him. So yeah, like I said, guys, EA counters are tough. Don't feel bad if you don't get them right away. Find yourself a nice training partner. and only focus on doing them. That's how I do it, and yeah. Happy hunting, guys. Keep at it.